Yeah, what the fuck is that thumbnail? Ah, chat, don't, man. It's a mobile game, not only the game, is it? Chat, someone send me a link.
How things have changed.
Someone send me a link about it. It's got crossplay as well, right? Someone send me a link. It's got crossplay and it's changed its name.
Capacity crowds, that familiar cacophony of sound, the mass chorus of emotions, just some of the familiar norms on any given match day. All these things we used to take for granted, but as the old saying goes, only appreciated once they are gone. The last 25 years, we have prided ourselves on recreating the ultimate footballing experience for our fans worldwide.
Us
being the platform for them to share in their zenith, as well as their
nadir.
And this will continue to be our mission. Uniting all football fans in this new normal with the same undying passion. Better yet, with a new level of passion. This is what eFootball...
Jabbers, I'm bored already. Like, who makes a 6-minute trailer, man? Well, people don't have the attention span these days. Certainly, I don't.
...is all about.
Yeah, as long as you... Let's bring it up. You just business like 10 years behind. Let's see, man. In conclusion, it's really like water down to one of the one kids because of like a single match with the mobile. Yeah, am I on the right one?
Look down, locked in, brain up in the spin. I don't know what is happening, don't know what is happening. Squeeze got me in limbo, tie your book and I can do. Display me trying to spin do.
Wait. Oh, someone told me you can go back. But how does that?
Squeeze got me in limbo.
Bro, Lewandowski looks weird as fuck. Sané looks fine. Bro, my first glance was on Lewandowski. He looks weird as fuck. I personally, I don't care how players look. I'm not one of those paper, but he looks a little bit weird. Morata looks amazing, so does Dybala. I don't know who that is. That's supposed to be Chiesa. Oh, dearie me. Who the fuck is this? Is that Alexandro? No, this is Sandro. Oh, Danilo, right? Yeah. Usually their strong point is their graphics, nah? Bro, what the fuck is that? Rabiot looks good though. Cuadrado looks good. Obviously, I don't really give a shit. It's tough. Whatever. I'm pausing because so I don't have to go back. Like, apologies. I can't be scrolling back and shit. It looks like it doesn't really look like a next gen game, does it? What the fuck? That tell me that slowed down. They have money to pay for Messi and shit.
There is one overriding question. Creating the greatest head-to-head experience is our ultimate goal. But how would the game need to evolve for us to achieve this? The answer is simple, from the bottom up, refining the most fundamental of all elements in football, the one-on-one.
We're doing well. We're going to time it perfectly.
The mantra of eFootball. Andres Iniesta is without doubt one of the true
legends. I swear they do this every time. I show Iniesta every time it's there. I mean, it's better to have Iniesta than that fucking Botti.
Surely, incorporating his movements, as well as the thought processes behind his wizardry, would be an unmissable step in elevating eFootball to the dizzy heights of next-gen entertainment.
Creo que tiene el balón siempre tiene ventaja.
That's what Messi hace. Yeah, okay. Nah, give him that. Like, Iniesta, Messi,
lo que hace es defensa, que solo puede intuir o pensar lo que voy a hacer para quitarme el balón.
I don't like this.
Sobre el espacio.
I don't like this.
Like,
I rather see it from a game point of view.
El regate, ¿no? Jugar con el engaño y intentar pues.
Oh, you're kidding me, man. I know what to do in Iniesta, man. Don't worry, Andres.
Start the ball, and in that moment, when you do it, it's rapid.
At least they're realistic.
Football, of course, isn't all about attack. We also need to know what makes great defense.
Oh, ball off, man.
Cuanto menos terreno de falta, siempre en el momento en que de lo habitual del final.
Engagement and responsive one-on-one in eFootball to an all-new level. Realistic player movement and responses are both crucial ingredients in creating our new one-on-one system. How did we do it? Through the use of technology known as motion matching. Motion matching involves creating a massive range of new animations, showing just how players react differently depending on factors such as running speed and ball position.
Bloody hell.
These animations are then cut and perfectly
matched. He got sent like that. He didn't do anything crazy, he got sent back
down to a T. And the
result, but I don't like seeing this shit, like this is not a
game. We have created a one-on-one system that is incredibly thrilling and, most importantly, realistic.
This is big, eh? This is big.
We want eFootball to be a thing for all fans of football. And for that, it was imperative that users on all platforms can take on each other. eFootball will be made available on a wide range of different platforms to business.
How many? Is this what you said, mobile?
We want eFootball to be a thing for all fans.
Well, I can play against mobile people.
Path to
no, surely. Why? Even the PC, I don't like. PC scare me a little bit. They're a bunch of hackers.
And for that, it was I'd rather keep that the users on all platforms can Xbox take on each other. eFootball will be made available on a wide range of devices, with a view to soon making it a fully cross-platform title. After all, why should you be bound by the confines of your device? Why can't a mobile user play against a console user just by plugging
in? They're not wrong. I'm not a fan of
it. For everyone.
Neymar. Puro talento, extraordinario, tremendo pase, puede estar. Wow. Messi, 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 golazo.
Y fútbol.
I'll be honest, like.
So, guess you're all desperate to find out what eFootball can offer at a game.
Oh, hang on. Early autumn, all new game engine rollout, local matches, using renowned clubs. Cross-generation matches, PS5 versus PS4, Xbox versus Xbox One. Wait, what? Didn't they say they're gonna be?
Gaming level.
Match pass, cross-platform. Oh, so this is PlayStation against Steam against Xbox. Autumn. Oh, this comes later on. Yeah, you reckon I can dominate the eSport? I think I can if I start from the beginning. I think I won them all. Remember, like when I tried PES last time, yeah, I literally came in at like April, you know?
In that case.
Wait. Do it. It took them 2 years to make a fucking mobile game. Wait. So the game's gonna release with this. And then in autumn. Wait, so when the game gets released, we can only play this? Huh? That can't be right, can it? And then this comes later. Oh, come on, man. Well, people will give up by that point, like, if they're not gonna get... did I get that right, chat? Oh, it's a demo, so this is like the demo version. Why? I wonder what this is. Team building mode. Online leagues. Wait, this is local. Oh, this is demo. Oh! Oh, okay, right. So this is the demo. Yeah, it's free to play. Everything's free to play, nah? Or not? And then we move on to this. Autumn, I'm guessing it's so in the official. Team building mode. This is their ultimate team, right? I'm sorry, right? Like, the game can be good. Like, gameplay matters, don't get me wrong. But they have to nail this. Because if they don't make a much superior game to FIFA... Then if this is shit again, like my club is, my club to me is lazy. Like even that, I'm looking at this menu. I'm gonna be honest, chat. Like this marketing shit. Like if they can afford to pay Messi and Neymar and shit, they should invest in some better graphics. Hopefully, better modes like they've done. I don't know what this is. I don't know. I'll be honest. I didn't learn shit, man. It's a waste of 6 minutes. Yeah, it's cross-platform and it's free to play. No gameplay whatsoever. FIFA had more gameplay than this shit yesterday.